Hi, gute YouTube. This is Max and you're watching Random Old School Yu-Gi-Oh! And today I want to open three reprint classic packs, being Pharaoh's Servant, Metal Raiders and Dark Crisis, plus a special edition blister, you could call it, of Dark Revelation Volume 3. And because I love opening stuff which I have to struggle to open on camera, I brought my scissors to kind of accelerate the process. That should do it. Maybe. Or maybe not. Just some general thoughts. I think those blister packs are a pain. Because first of all, it's very hard to open them. And number two, which is the bigger reason I don't like them, is because Yu-Gi-Oh! Products tend to have a lot of stuff that goes into the trash can afterwards. And yeah, that's not too nice. So booster boxes are okay, I think. But those blister packs where you have like 20 cards in that much of trash, shouldn't be done like this, in my opinion. As a promo card, there's a Dragon Master Knight, Iha. And I think let's start with the newer packs, at least newer in terms of the date that those specific packs were printed. Of course, original booster packs would be way older than DR3. first card, Frozen Soul, Rod of Silence, Kayest, Shadow Knight Archfiend, Drag Down into the Grave, and Mephis the Infernal General. I ran this, but not too often, in my Fiend decks. Pharaoh's Servant is next. Sword Hunter. That was a short print in the original packs. Oh, cool! An ultra rare, Chain Destruction. I'm not sure if I pulled this out of reprints yet, so I have a binder where I put the reprint cards, all of them that I pull, to maybe get a full set of Invasion of Chaos, LOB, Pharaoh's Servant, etc. So that's appreciated and will go in there. I'm like 50-50 if I have Chain Destruction in there yet. Kisai Tai, Drillbug, Gamble, Dark Bat, and going on to Metal Raiders. One ultra rare out of three loose packs is nice. Maybe. Just maybe. Oh, Mushroom Man number two. Punished Eagle. Muka Muka. We used to love this card back in the day. In the very, very early days. It was in Starter Deck Pegasus, I think. And things like a hand size limit were nothing we knew about. And also the games were so slow that you could just, yeah, set a 2k defender and nobody would get over it. And you could harvest cards in your hand until Muka Muka got really big. So there are, let's see, 12 cards in every DR3 pack. And the reprints go to the early GX sets, I think. Abare Ushioni, Harpy Lady 2, Homunculus, the Alchemic Being, Catnipped Kitty, Iria, whatever, the Water Charmer. Oh, that's sick! Cool, it's so tough to pull ultra rares or even super rares out of the set. And Silent Swordsman level 5. Nice, 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 nice. Ooh, I didn't expect this. Nice. Let's set this one aside. I think... Okay, so the ratio is 1 in 12. Still, like in the other packs. I thought it was tougher. I thought it was like 1 in 24. Because it's GX era and no ultimates in here. But okay, I'm taking it nonetheless. Threatening Roar. I put lots of those in my Flaming Eternity booster packs. Whatever that is. Nice. So, I'm already happy that I opened this. It was lingering in my cupboard for, yeah, 1 or 2 years now, and I thought I only have one of those, so should I keep it or not? Whoops. That's the right direction. Heater, the Fire Charmer. Pitch Black Warwolf. Creeping Doom Manta. Moai Interceptor Cannons. Hand of Neftis. Moki Moki King. And Necklace of Command. So a TLM card, and a pretty bad one at that. But an ultra rare out of the first pack calms my mind, I would say. The graveyard in the fourth dimension. Okay. So I opened five packs in total. I got 2 ultra rares. That's not too bad. Thank you for watching, stay safe, and as always, see you next time on Random Old School Yu-Gi-Oh! Goodbye.